Doing a great job on this place.
Well, at least it's better than it was.
Yeah. What, are you going for the rustic look on purpose here?
No. Just happened that way.
This is crazy.
What?
The whole thing, you know? Finding ourselves working in the same place.
And finding ourselves living in the same building, yes. It is rather strange, isn't it?
Do you think fate's trying to tell us something?
Could be. I don't know.
Well, that's it for me.
Yeah, I guess me too.
Oh, look, I'm gonna leave you the bottle.
Oh, that's nice. Maybe I'll make it into a lamp base or something.
Oh, that'd be nice. I really do wish you a Merry Christmas.
I wish you one, too.
Thanks. Happy birthday again.
Oh, thank you again.
Good night.
Good night.
You get your keys and I'll hold this magnificent piece of forest.
Don't make jokes, please.
Sorry. Oh, on second thought, you hold the forest because I have the magic touch. Remember? All right?
All right.
All right.
All yours.
Thank you, ma'am. Whoops. Oh. Well, maybe I only have the magic touch at night.
Let me help you with that.
All right, here we go.
Ready?
Ready?
1, 2, 3.
All right. Well, Smokey the Bear, here comes Christmas. Ooh, ain't that nice?
Okay, well, now that I have finished tending your garden, it is time for your daily walk.
No, I think I'd like to pass on that today.
Why? Is there some report you want me to make?
Oh, no. I'm just not into it.
Well, listen. Walking is part of your therapy, so out of that bed, kid, and walk.
Yeah. You know, you'd make a hell of an army drill sergeant, you know that? A very pretty one, but a very real army drill sergeant.
Okay, well, thanks a lot. But hot too, mister. I'm going to toss away your tree.
Hey, all right. Now, I don't want you to do that, because that was like a very special present to me from Laura Baldwin, you know? So.
Oh, yeah? What's so special about a present from Laura Baldwin?
Well, she just kind of reminds me of my ex-wife.
Hello?
Is this Alexandria?
It's you.
Yes, I'm sorry you recognized me last night at the Christmas party when I was playing butler.
Yes, I'm sure you were very sorry.
Mm. Well, just because I didn't find the Ice Princess at the Quartermain House.
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
It doesn't mean that you haven't got it hidden somewhere else. Perhaps with a friend?
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Is it? I saw the boxes and crates marked Rio. I know that's how you smuggled the Ice Princess back into the country after taking it from us.
I just want to remind you, Alexandria, that the Cassedines will not give up until they get the Ice Princess back. Do you understand what I'm talking about?
I haven't the foggiest idea what you're talking about, and leave me alone!
Look at it with me. Tell me what you think.
I love it. It's great.
You're a liar.
Yes, I am. I don't know. You know, maybe tomorrow or in a couple of days, maybe the branch... It'll look better when the branches kind of fall out a little bit.
I certainly hope not. There'll be nothing left of it.
All right, look on the bright side. It had to be cheap. What'd you do, get the last tree in town?
Actually, I think I got a leftover from last year. I mean, these needles are so dry. Maybe if I just, you know, throw tons and tons of tinsel on it, it'll make it look fuller.
Well, some people live that way, with tons and tons of tinsel covering up the emptiness. Ooh, I like that.
Listen, thanks a lot. You're really a big help. I'm gonna sweep up a little before I go to work.
What time are you going into work? I mean, it's Christmas Eve and all, you know.
Oh, not until later this morning.
Oh, well, I'm not going in until later either. I'll give you a ride if you want. I'm going to stop off at an employment agency first.
Employment agency?
Yeah, and then I'm going to go by the hospital. I got a little something for Hutch.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I got something for him, too.
Yeah? Well, then, great. We'll stop there on our way to work, huh?
Luke, listen, what happened last night, you know, was one thing with the cab driver having the flat tire and everything, and he couldn't take me to the Quartermain.
Yeah, well, all right, so I just happened to be going by, so I gave you a ride. So what's wrong with that?
Nothing. Nothing. It's terrific. I just don't want you to think that because you're living in the same building and everything that I'm going to be imposing on you.
Laura, you're not imposing. I offered. You didn't ask.
Okay, I'm not going to argue.
Good.
Luke.
Yeah?
If we're living in the same building, that could bring back the reporters.
Yeah, I know it could.
So have you decided to be a gentleman, move out?
Well, I'm always a gentleman.
Oh, good. Then it's settled.
Yes, it is settled. I'm not going to move out. I thought it over very carefully when I came home from the party last night, and I'm not going to move out. So what if we live in the same building? If it brings the reporters around, so what?
What if Alex orders you to move out?